Biological sulfur reduction is a microbial mediated process where sulfate is reduced to sulfide. This sulfide can be used to recover metals as sulfidic precipitates. It is a step forward from using chemical sulfide, as it eliminates the cost associated with the acquisition of sulfide reagents. Key advantages of using the biological sulfur reduction process are that it uses a pollutant mainly present in wastewaters, and it allows the production of sulfide on site, which avoids transportation costs as well as health and safety of hazardous chemicals. Biological sulfur reduction has been assessed at full scale to treat acid mine drainage and to recover metals such as copper and zinc from wastewaters coming from metallurgical processes. The process relies on the activity of sulfate-reducing bacteria, which are strict anaerobic microorganisms found in a wide range of natural and engineered environments, including wetlands, sediments, and wastewater sludge. They are capable of reducing sulfate autotrophically and heterotrophically. This means that they can use as electron donor and carbon source hydrogen and carbon dioxide or biodegradable organic compounds. The outcome of this metabolism is hydrogen sulfide and bicarbonate ions in the case of complete oxidation. And when incomplete oxidation occurs, also acetate as byproduct. The sulfide produced is then used for metal precipitation and the alkalinity produced, which increases the pH of the wastewater. The majority of the wastewaters containing metals lack of organic compounds, so the selection of a degradable, cost-effective, available, and non-pollutant electron donor becomes crucial for the process. For this, several aspects are considered in choosing an electron donor, including the degradation feasibility of the organic compound and the biomass yield, the cost of the electron donor per unit of sulfide produced, the local availability of the electron donor, and the production of byproducts that can cause pollution or toxicity problems. In the last years, a considerable diversity of electron donors has been used in sulfate-reducing bioreactors at lab scale, while only a few have tested at full scale. These include ethanol and hydrogen. Maximum growth rate of different sulfate-reducing bacteria is lower as compared to other microbial communities used in other biotechnological recovery technologies, which reduces excess biomass management, but advocates for maximizing biomass retention in bioreactors. Parameters governing biological processes in bioreactors include pH, sulfide concentration, inhibitors concentration, hydraulic retention time, and electron donor and sulfate loading rates. Many studies at lab, pilot, and full scale have successfully demonstrated the application of the sulfate reduction process for wastewater streams, even at pH values below 2.5. This is because the process itself generates the bicarbonate ions, which increases the pH of the wastewater up to 7. However, sulfur reduction at pH out of this range is attractive for metal recovery purposes. This is because the manipulation of the pH in a wider range than neutral in bioreactors can allow selective precipitation and thus selective recovery in multi-metal wastewaters. pH is also an important parameter because it determines the predominant species in the system. Undissociated sulfide and organic compounds occur at low pH values and affect the functioning of metabolic coenzymes and denaturing proteins due to cell membrane penetration. Over the last years, different bioreactors have been studied for sulfur reduction and treatment of metal-containing waste streams. This has been done in a single stage or in a multi-stage processes. These bioreactors include completely stirred tank reactor, off-flow anaerobic packed bed reactor, gas lift reactor, off-flow anaerobic sludge blanket reactor, and off-flow fluidized bed reactor, and downflow as well. The classification of these systems can be based on the flow mode, whether it's batch or is semi-continuous, biomass retention, which is whether it's suspended or attached, a state of the substrate use, liquid, solid, and gas phase, and whether it is being carried out in single stage or in many stages. Sulfur reduction for metal recovery at full scale is predominantly performed in a multi-stage process, consisting of a biological stage, a sulfur-reducing bioreactor, and a precipitation stage that has a separated or joint settling stage. From these configurations, gas lift reactor and upflow anaerobic sludge blanket reactors, along with fluidized bed reactors, are the most widely used. The configurations used depend on the flow mode, biomass retention, state of the substrate use, and whether it is possible or not to recover metals in a single stage, or if it requires additional stages. The Nierstar plant in the Netherlands, that will be later discussed, treats a processed wastewater containing zinc sulfate, where sulfur reduction takes place in a gas lift reactor with hydrogen as electron donor.